Hey everyone, thanks for sticking around this afternoon. It's been great to see everybody. My name's Keith Smiley. I work at Lyft on developer experience and stuff that includes Bazel. And today I'm gonna talk about how we started using Bazel to build a Rust library that we deploy on iOS and Android. So our primary goal here is to kind of share code across platforms. And this kind of has a negative connotation in the mobile ecosystem, but you know, realistically, a lot of companies with significant scale, like start doing C or C++ across platform. And you know, there's some obvious benefits being able to not write things twice, not introduce bugs in one platform and not the other. But really what I'm talking about today is like lower level libraries where you know, they're not super platform dependent. So you know, we're not showing UI from these things or anything like that. And you know, maybe they're performance critical, but that wasn't as much our case as it could be for others. I'm happy to talk more about this outside about you know the benefits or downsides of doing that. You might also wonder why Rust as opposed to C or C++, which I've already mentioned. And I think you know for us the answer is pretty much why you hear most people choosing Rust over C or C++. I think you know one, it's much more natural for engineers who come from mobile backgrounds where they're probably used to writing Swift or Kotlin. They may not have a big background in C or C++, and we don't want them to hit all the same issues that everyone hits all the time. So that's a really nice reason to use Rust. We're also specifically interested in you know, safety around like multi-threading use cases that you know, it's much easier to get right when the borrow checker is making sure you do. But also happy to talk more about that offline. If you've used Rust and Bazel, you know about Rules Rust, which is a really great rule set out there for building Rust in general, and it supports a bunch of stuff. So you might wonder, like, shouldn't this kind of example just work? If you swapped this Rust library for a CC library and you threw in like a C source, this would just work. So you know, what's going on here? And I'm going to talk a little bit about some of the issues we hit. So first off, you may be familiar with this concept already, but Bazel's moving to this world where you describe what you're building for using this platform's API. And you know, you may not have to know about this if you're you know, developing on a Linux x86 laptop and deploying to a Linux x86 server or something like that. But of course, in the mobile world, you're never building and deploying on the same hardware. You're like building on some you know, Mac OS ARM64 machine, deploying to an iOS ARM64 machine or something like that. And you know, because of that, we have to tell Bazel somehow you know, what's the sysroot, what's the SDK, like things like that, what compiler flags apply for this platform. And theoretically, you know, you use this new nice platforms representation and the rules know how to use this. But of course, if this works, there would be no talk. So, you know, here's a kind of a funny issue where we were talking about this and whether or not this would make it into Bazel 0.25, which was a while ago. And unfortunately, this is still the case. There's some kind of light at the end of the tunnel here. Hopefully by Bazel 7, that will just work. But in the meantime, it doesn't. So the question here is, if Rules Rust does things the right way and supports these nice platform things, and mobile doesn't support these platform things, you know, what do we do? And luckily, Bazel has a nice migration path for this called platform mappings, which is a file you throw in your workspace that looks something like this. And you can read this as, if I pass these compiler flags, we're building for this platform. You might see some flags that you don't recognize or something like that, but you know, mostly you just copy paste this from someone else's repo and you don't worry about it anymore. And then hopefully with Bazel 7, you just delete it and move on. So this is the minimum to get you know, Rust compiling at all for mobile. But then of course, you hit more issues. So the next thing you find is that there are some you know, undefined symbols that you probably don't recognize, even if you're a Rust engineer, because you're like, what is that? Those aren't even you know, mangled Rust symbols. And this kind of points to a bigger issue, which is who links the binaries in this kind of case. So you know, in a typical Rust project or a typical C or C++ project, you have a lot of like library targets that are all the same language, and then you probably link them into some final binary target that's also all the same language. But of course, in our mobile example, there are actually three different tools that could do the linking. There's like the Rust compiler, there's Clang, and then there's the Swift compiler. And so that's kind of what the issue is here, which is if you were using Rust to link, it would be like, oh, you know, you're linking some Rust. I'm gonna throw in these helper things for you and everything will be fine. But you know, Clang has no idea what Rust is. So when we're linking with that, because our top level binary is like some Objective-C or something, you know, you get these errors. And luckily the answer in this case is just copy some code from Chromium because they have the exact same problem and forget about it. So now that you actually have things building and linking, you might wonder like, how do I actually use this thing? And of course, it also requires some work. So the easiest way to kind of bridge Rust to mobile platforms is to kind of go through some C API. So if you have some very simple Rust functions like these, you know, one with some side effects and one returning a simple value, you can kind of bridge these to C with the example at the bottom, and then you can just call those from iOS. Or, you know, from Android, you do something similar for the JNI. But you can obviously tell that this one function barely fits on a slide, so you know it's not going to be the best way to do things. And there are some really nice projects out there that help generate these bindings for you. So if, especially if you have complex interfaces, you can kind of generate the bindings, you know, and then you can bridge it through to the actual native platform. In our case, I think we found that, you know, the fewer APIs, the better that you're trying to go, you know, between the two languages of. But it's not particularly bad for the low-level use case where maybe your library has like one or two entry points, and we, you know, maybe use these to generate some interface that we expose to Swift or Kotlin or something like that, and then, you know, people calling into the library think that they're just calling Swift or Kotlin. They have no idea that Rust is under the hood. But you probably have to get into these pretty quick if you're doing anything more complex than that. So there's still a lot of issues in general. You know, one is developer experience. So today, for us, the difference in developer experience from working on this Rust for mobile stuff versus normal mobile stuff, it's like very different. You're using maybe a different IDE, it's in a different repo, a different debugger, or something like that. And I think this is kind of fine if you're doing what we're doing, which is you're deploying a small library, one team works on this, and then, you know, most mobile engineers have no idea that there's Rust in the code base and you don't think about it. But I think if you were trying to use it for more things, share more code across the platforms, you'd really have to solve this better than we have. There's also a question of what is the future of Rust supporting mobile. So I'm not sure how many folks are using mobile Rust today, but today Rust considers iOS and Android to be a tier two platform, which is scarier, I think. It sounds scarier than it actually is, because I think mostly that means that it should continue working, but maybe not everything is tested on it. But I'm kind of hoping that the Rust community you know, spend some more time on this, because I think it's a really valuable language that you could use in place of these C or C++ use cases. So you might wonder, like, well, this seems like a lot of work. Like, is this worth doing at all? And so there are nice, some nice positives I want to highlight. So, you know, one, like I said earlier, I think developers are much happier, in, at least in our case, you know, writing Rust than if they had to write C++, especially folks with a mobile background. I think, you know, we find very few mobile engineers come in with a strong background in C or C++. And so I think Rust is definitely better in that case. Of course, you know, like I said a little bit earlier, also most of this is just one-time setup, and you've done it, and now you're done, and now you can keep building Rust. You can add all you want, and it's no problem. But I also think this was a nice, you know, exercise for Bazel. So this is kind of a case where, you know, we fixed a lot of things. We tried to fix as many things as we could upstream, and now if folks try to migrate to Bazel in the future who already have this kind of interop, you know, hopefully it's a slightly easier path for them than it was for us. So I made this repo if folks want to mess around with it. It has an iOS and an Android app that are calling some REST APIs, and you can run them and kind of see all the workarounds that are in there. I also put in a ton of comments so you can see all the details. I also upstreamed this to the Rules REST repo. I don't know if any of the Rules REST maintainers are here, but thank you for that. So theoretically, changes to Rules REST are now tested against mobile platforms as well, so it should continue working over time. I also have this huge list of issues that is relevant to this. And if you're interested in that, I will tweet a link afterwards. But thanks, everyone. I'm happy to talk about this more in the hall.